Students, today we are going to see the fourth lesson of our science. The name of fourth lesson is Current Electricity and Magnetism. See students, in last standard we have studied the constituents of atom. So you tell me which are the main constituents of atom. Students, please revise in last standard what you have to study related to the atom. So students, yes, think about that. So students, in atom there are three constituents. First one is positively charged protons, negatively charge electrons and the chargeless neutrons. These are the main constituents of atom. See here students, an atom has same number of positively charged protons and negatively charged electrons. Student, you know that in atom the number of positively charged protons which are situated in the nucleus of the atom and the negatively charged electrons which are revolving around the nucleus are having the same count. So an object doesn't show any charge through its atoms contain charged particles. Because of that, positively charged protons and negatively charged electrons, the number of that two protons and electrons are same. So the resulting charge present on the atom or an object is null. So there is no charge on object or an atom. Therefore, we can say that plenty of electric charge is filled in the objects around us. What will happen if a glass, see here student, there are some questions. What will happen if a glass rod is rubbed on a silk cloth? See here student, in last standard there is an experiment related to that question. So please remember that and give me the answer of this question. What will happen if a glass rod is rubbed on a silk cloth? See here student, I will give the answer of that question. When a glass rod is rubbed with silk cloths, glass quickly loses its electrons and silk takes electrons out of the glass rod. So because of that transfer of electrons, glass rod become positively charged and silk get negative charge because the negative charge of glass is transferred toward the silk. So the positive charges on glass is increases and the negative charges on silk is increases. So glass is positively charged and silk is negatively charged. See here student, the next question is, how do objects get charges? How do objects get charges? See here students, an electrical charge is created when electrons are transferred to or removed from an object because electrons have a positive charge. When they are added to an object, it becomes positively charged, and when electrons are removed from the object, it becomes negatively charged. In first question we see how glass acquired positive charge and how silk acquired negative charge. So about that phenomenon or that because of that process, objects get charges, either positive or either negative. See here next question, what are static and moving charges? See here student, static charges means the charges are at the rest and these static charges are accumulating on the surface of the insulator. Means if we rub glass and silk cloth on that glass and silk, there is a static electrical charges. So these charges are present on the surface and they are at the rest. So that type of charges are called as static charges. And the moving charges are, the electrons are moving inside the conductor. Moving charges means what, students? The electrons which are present in the conductor, they are moving on. Because of that moving of electrons, the charges are produced, or that charges are called as moving charges. See here, student. Next, moving charges get transferred from one object to the other. These are negatively charged. Moving negatively charged particles are the electrons. So student, please remember that the moving charged particles are always electrons, and we know that these are the negatively charged particles. Can this negative charge charge be made to flow? Yes, these negative charge are flow, and because of that flowing of electrons, electric current or electricity is produced. Can electricity be made to flow like water flowing from higher to lower level? So that this is we are going to study in this chapter, current, electricity and magnetism. You have learned that a force will have to be applied to put a stationary object into motion. So we get the current, electricity, when the electrons in an electrical conductor are made to flow. See here, now we see the current, electricity. So students, this is a metallic wire. So see here, students, current, electricity means what we are going to study. See here, what is meant by current, electricity? A current, electricity is a simple electrons flowing along a path. So current, electricity is the process of simple process of moving or flowing the electrons along a path. So see here, student, a large current flows when lightning takes place from a cloud to the ground, while sensation is felt by us due to microscopically small current flowing to the brain. You are aware of the current flowing through wires, electric bulbs and equipments in house. In the electric cells of a ratio or in a car battery, a current is produced by the flow of both negatively and positively charged particles. See here, students, now we are going to see the current, electricity. So see here, there is a metallic wire, and in metallic wire, these red colors are the free electrons. What are these? These are the free electrons. So if we apply a battery here, see here, flow, this is a battery. Student, please see on the screen, this is a battery. This is the positive terminal of battery and this is the negative terminal of battery. If we join this electric wire, this is the electric wire. In this wire, electrons are free flowing. If we join this battery to this electrical wire with the help of this conducting wire, or this is called as insulator wire. Because of that, the flow of electron is in specific direction. See here, from negative to positive means from higher potential to lower potential. So this is the flow of conventional current from positive to negative. Current flows from positive to negative, and electrons flows from negative to positive, from higher potential to lower potential. This is the way of flow of electrons from higher potential to lower potential. See here, students, and flow of conventional current is from positive to negative. So this is the current, electricity, or this is the process of flowing free electrons in a specific direction and producing the current, electricity. city. So see here students, now we are see the next point, electric potential. So see the students, what is meant by electric potential? See here, water or a liquid flows from higher level to a lower level. We know that water or any liquid, that is flow from higher level to lower level, like in waterfall, water flows from higher level to lower level. And heat always flows from a body at higher temperature to a body of lower temperature. We know that heat is also produced from the higher temperature to lower temperature. So what is the example for this? See here students, if we are in kitchen, see here kitchen madhe ja vela apan chaha vagere kai tari karayla jato, tar chaha cha je bhanda asta tela ek pakadnyasathi holding asto, ek danda asto tela, thik aahe, ani ja vela te patel garam hoto halu halu pat heat gas chi heat ja bajuni aahe khalcha bajuni तिथून गरम होत होत ते जे चहाचं भांड आहे ते वरपर्यंत गरम होतं, म्हणजे हीट इज ऑलवेज ट्रान्सफ्लोज फ्रॉम द ए बॉडी ऑफ हायर टेम्परेचर टू ए बॉडी ऑफ लोअर टेम्परेचर. सिमिलरली देअर इज अ टेंडन्सी ऑफ द पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज टू फ्लो फ्रॉम पॉइंट ऑफ हायर इलेक्ट्रिक लेवल टू ए पॉइंट ऑफ लोअर इलेक्ट्रिकल लेवल. दिस इलेक्ट्रिक लेवल डिसाइडिंग द direction of flow of electric charges is called as electrostatic potential. So students, in simple words, what is meant by electrostatic potential? The electrostatic potential means the energy required to move a single charge from one point to another point, that is called as electrostatic potential. I will see here student, listen carefully, what is electrostatic potential? Electrostatic potential means energy required to move a single charge from a point to another point is called as electrostatic potential. So see here student, next point is potential difference. What is meant by potential difference? Similar to the height of waterfall or temperature difference of hot and cold bodies, the difference between the potential of two points, that is potential difference. So what is it? Is simple, it is very very simple. What is potential difference? The difference of electrical potential between two points. The potential means what? The difference of electrical potential between two points is called as potential difference. See here, so students, now next point is the electrical circuit. See here students, in our textbook there are two diagrams, 4.1 and 4.1a and 4.1b. So students, you have to self study on these two activities. ह्या ज्या ॲक्टिव्हिटीज आहेत त्या तुम्ही काय करायच्या आहेत, तुमच्या घरी करायच्या आहेत, ठीक आहे. आता दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट. व्हॉट यू हॅव टू डू, टेक कनेक्टिंग कॉपर वायर्स अँड कनेक्ट द सर्किट ॲज शोन इन 4.1a. नो करंट इज सीन टू फ्लो इन द बल्ब. सी हियर देअर इज अ ओनली सिम्पल बल्ब अँड द कंडक्टिंग वायर, ऑर वी कॅन सी द कनेक्टिंग वायर, कॉपर वायर. सो बिकॉज दीज ओनली दीज टू बल्ब अँड वायर, देअर इज अ नो करंट इन द बल्ब ऑर नो फ्लो इन द बल्ब. नाव इन द सेम सर्किट ए 1.5 होल्ट ड्राय सेल अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट ॲज शोन इन फिगर 4.1b. नाव इट विल बी रिअलाइज्ड फ्रॉम ग्लोइंग द बल्ब that a current is flowing in the circuit. If we join any dry cell or any battery to this circuit, and because of that battery the bulb start to flow. Here electrons in the wire flow due to the potential difference between the two ends of dry cell. This is the dry cell, and because of that potential difference, the electrons in the wire are flow. See here, this flow from the negative terminal of the cell to the positive terminal of the cell. The hado electrons cell hai to negative pasun positive kade flow hoto. Conventional current flows in the opposite direction as shown in the figure. Conventional current jo ahe, so that is conventional current flows from the positive to negative, and electrons are flows from the negative to positive. See here, so there is no current as in figure 4.1a. There is no potential difference in the absence of any cell. Current starts flowing in the circuit as soon as the potential difference is applied. What is the unit of potential difference, students? The SI unit of potential difference is volt. See, what is the unit of potential difference? Volt. Okay, so see students, this is the diagram of simple electric circuit. There is a bulb, there is a battery, and there is a plug key. If we join this battery to a circuit and if we on the plug, then bulb flows. This is the battery or electric cell. So students, we have seen the electric current is produced due to the flow of charged particles. Electrical charge flowing through a wire in 1 second can be called unit current. The SI unit of electric current is coulomb per second, or it is also called as ampere. So 1 ampere or 1A is equal to 1 coulomb per second, is equal to 1 coulomb per second. And electric current is a scalar quantity because electric current having direction, so because, and magnitude also, so because of that electric current is a scalar quantity. So students, see, next point is electric cell. So what is the electric cell? Electric cell is a device capable of generate electrical energy from chemical energy. So we know in market there are different types of cells are available. So by using these cells, or in these cells there is a chemical reaction, and because of that chemical reaction it generates the electricity, or that device is called as electrical cell. So see here student, electrical cell, a source is required to produce a uniform flow of charges in a circuit. Such general device is an electric cell. Various types of electrical cells are available today. These are used in the range of machines from wristwatches to submarines. Out of these, you must be aware of solar cells. Students, we know that in wristwatches we use the cell. In games also, or in remotes also, or in जे काही लहान मुलांची खेळणी असतात त्याच्यामध्ये आपण जे काही डिफरंट टाईपचे सेल्स यूज करतो ते सेल म्हणजे इलेक्ट्रिकल सेल. आपल्या घरी टॉर्च असते, त्या टॉर्चमध्ये आपण सेल यूज करतो, दॅट इज इलेक्ट्रिकल सेल. द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ व्हेरियस इलेक्ट्रिक सेल इज टू मेंटेन ए कॉन्स्टंट पोटेन्शियल डिफरन्स बिटवीन इट्स टू टर्मिनल्स. द इलेक्ट्रिक सेल्स वर्क ऑन द इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस टू मेंटेन ए कॉन्स्टंट पोटेन्शियल डिफरन्स, about which you will learn later. Okay, let us learn about the electric cells that we are used currently in use. So see, now we are going to see the next cell, that is dry cell. So dry cell are used in our radio sets, wall clocks and torches. These are available in 3 to 4 sizes. The construction of dry cell is as shown in figure. See here, there is a figure, and See, there is a figure. Now I am going to explain that figure. So see students, what is this? This is a diagram of dry cell. So if we take a dry cell and we remove its outer covering, inside we will find a whitish metal layer. This is zinc metal layer. सगळ्यात बाहेरचं जे आउटर कवरिंग आहे दॅट इज झिंक मेटल लेअर. दिस इज द निगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ अवर सेल. नाउ केअरफुली ब्रेक ओपन धिस लेअर. देअर इज अनदर लेअर इनसाइड अँड इलेक्ट्रोलाइट कंटेन्स निगेटिवली चार्ज्ड अँड पॉझिटिवली चार्ज्ड आयन्स इनसाइड द झिंक कोटिंग. देअर आर इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स that is positively and negatively charged ions. These are the carriers of electricity. The electrolyte je tacha zinc covering cha at madhe jo electrolyte ahe that electrolytes contain a wet pulp of zinc chloride and ammonium chloride. The wet pulp is zinc chloride and ammonium क्लोराईड. मुलांनो पहा, तुम्ही जर एखादं ड्राय सेल घेऊन तुमच्या घरी खराब ड्राय सेल असलं आणि ते तुम्ही जर फोडलं तर त्याच्यामध्ये एक वेट पल्प आपल्याला दिसतो किंवा ओलसर असं थोडंसं लिक्विड दिसतं आपल्याला. दॅट इज झिंक क्लोराईड अँड अमोनियम क्लोराईड. देअर इज अ ग्रॅफाईट रॉड. देअर इज अ ग्रॅफाईट रॉड ॲट द सेंटर ऑफ द सेल अँड दिस इज द पॉझिटिव्ह टर्मिनल. सो दिस रॉड इज अ graphite rod and this is the positive terminal of the cell. A paste of manganese dioxide is filled outside the rod and this is the positive rod of graphite. Behind this or outside the this rod there is a paste of manganese dioxide. Because of the chemical reaction of all these chemicals, electrical charge is produced on the two terminals. Graphite, this is positive graphite rod and this is negative zinc coating or zinc layer, and an electric circuit flows into the circuit. See here students, tumhala ata he dry cell cha je construction asel kiwa ti je diagram asel ti tumhala agdi vyavasthitpane kalaleli असेल. आता पहा स्टुडंट पुढे, ड्यू टू द वेट पल्प यूज्ड इन धिस सेल द केमिकल रिॲक्शन प्रोसीड्स व्हेरी स्लोली. याच्यामध्ये अमोनियम क्लोराईड आणि झिंक क्लोराईडचा जो वेट पल्प आहे त्याच्या त्या वेट पल्पमुळे त्याची जी केमिकल रिॲक्शन आहे ती कशी होते, इट इज व्हेरी स्लोली. हेन्स ए लार्ज स्टॅटिक लार्ज इलेक्ट्रिक करंट कॅनॉट बी ऑप्टेन फ्रॉम धिस. Compared to electric cells using liquids, the shelf life of dry cell is longer. Dry cells are very convenient to use as these can be held in any direction with respect to the ground and can be used in mobile instruments also. See here, the chemical reaction of dry cell is very slowly, so the shelf life of dry cell is long. See here, and these dry cells are not rechargeable cell. Je dry cells ahe, these are rechargeable cells nahi. So next type of cell is lead acid cell. See here students, this is the diagram of lead acid cell, or in your textbook this is also the diagram of lead acid cell. So in this figure, it is a design of lead acid cell. Let us examine its principle. We are going to study the lead acid cells here. This type of cell can be recharged after getting electrically discharged, like mobile ची जी बॅटरी असते याच्यामध्ये अशा टाईपची बॅटरी असते. The lead acid cell contains a lead electrode. See here, this is the lead electrode and this is negative. Lead electrode and a lead oxide electrode, that is lead oxide PB and PbO2, lead electrode that is negative
and lead oxide electrode, that is positive terminal, while the lead electrode carries a negative charge. The potential difference between these two is nearby 2 volt. The potential difference between these positive and negative means lead dioxide and lead यांच्यामधलं जे potential difference आहे it is nearly 2 volt because of the chemical reaction between the substances in the cell. Electrical charge is produced on the both electrodes and electric current flows through the load in the circuit. आता ह्याच्यामध्ये हा लीड डायऑक्साईड हा लीड आणि हा जो इलेक्ट्रोलाइट आहे H2SO4 यांच्यामध्ये रिॲक्शन होऊन इथे काय होतो इलेक्ट्रिक करंट जो आहे तो इलेक्ट्रिक करंट ह्या ठिकाणी प्रोड्यूस होतो. ठीक आहे, सो दिस इज द ऑल अबाउट द लीड ॲसिड सेल. सो स्टुडंट्स, ड्राय सेल अँड लीड ॲसिड सेल, दीज टू सेल्स आर व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट अँड इन एक्झाम ड्राय सेल आणि लीड ॲसिड सेल, दिस इज व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट इन द व्ह्यू ऑफ एक्झाम. सी हियर, सो स्टुडंट्स, नाव वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस लेसन, दॅट इज निकेल कॅडमियम सेल. सो आफ्टर बिफोर दिस दॅट वी सी द दिस काइंड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल सेल हॅव अ कपॅसिटी टू डिलिव्हर लार्ज करंट. हेन्स लीड ॲसिड सेल्स आर यूज्ड इन कार्स, ट्रक्स, मोटरसायकल अँड इंटरप्टेड पॉवर सप्लायर्स. सी हियर, इन अवर कार देअर इज अ बॅटरी, सो इन दॅट बॅटरी देअर इज लीड ॲसिड सेल्स आर यूज्ड इन सेरीज, यूज्ड इन पॅरलल. सो द कपॅसिटी ऑफ सेल इज इन्क्रीजेस. सो this is the uses of lead acid cell. This is used in car, truck, motorcycles or UPS, uninterrupted power supplies. So next point is nickel cadmium cell. So this is now we are going to see, these days a variety of gadgets are available which are required to be carried to different places. Such gadgets use nickel cadmium cells. The cells deliver 1.2 volt potential difference and these are rechargeable. ह्या ज्या lead acid cells आहेत दी type of cells are rechargeable. We can use these nickel cadmium cells afterwards. So this is the nickel, see here on screen students, there is a निकेल कॅडमियम बॅटरी सेल. दिस इज रिचार्जेबल बॅटरी. सी हियर अँड स्टुडंट्स, दिस इज द सेल होल्डर. वी अरेंज डिफरंट टाईप्स ऑफ सेल्स हियर अँड वी यूज द सेल्स इन अवर गॅजेट्स ऑर इन अवर ऑब्जेक्ट्स विच आर यूजफुल टू अस. सो स्टुडंट्स, टुडे we are studying the current electricity. In this current electricity we study what is meant by current electricity, electrostatic potential, what is meant by potential difference, what is meant by electric cell, and we see the two types of cell, three types of cells, a dry cell, lead acid cell and nickel cadmium cell. See here students, if you have any doubt you can ask me. See, so you have to complete the notes related to this topic in your notebook. See here, and please student, you have to do the activity of electrical circuit. Try to arrange the electrical circuit at your home with connecting wire, copper wire, one bulb and one small battery. And that battery is available in any shop. If suppose tumcha ghari asel battery, tar tumhi try to study about the electrical circuit and how electrical circuit completes and how that bulb blows. So see here students, now this is the simple electric circuit. You must have to see the electric circuit at your home, and you have to do that activity at your home. See here, because आपल्याकडे बल्ब, छोटा बल्ब असतो, बॅटरी असते, कनेक्टिंग वायर, दॅट मीन्स कॉपर वायर पण आपल्या घरी असते. तर त्याच्याशी रिलेटेड हे जे सिंपल इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट आहे, तुम्ही ते घरी काय करायचं आहे, बनवण्याचा प्रयत्न करायचा आहे. ठीक आहे, आणि ह्या लेसनचा जो उरलेला पार्ट असेल, तो रिमेनिंग पार्ट जो आहे, तो आपण उद्याच्या पिरियडमध्ये घेऊया. ठीक आहे, इफ यू हॅव एनी डाऊट्स, एनी क्वेरीज, प्लीज आस्क मी. ओके, थँक्यू.